Dear friends, today the church celebrates the feast of Saint Francis of Assisi, often known as the little poor man, who touched the lives of so many people of different faith over 800 years. G.K. Chesterton beautifully said about Francis of Assisi, as someone being a poet whose whole life was a poem. And we know what this poem consisted of. Francis embracing a leper. Christ telling Francis, "Go and rebuild my broken church." Francis stripping himself naked and abandoning his possession to follow Christ. Francis was probably the first person to have been ever recorded about having the stigmata. Francis lived a very simple and humble life. He preached to the birds, converted the wolf, and fasted for 40 days with just half loaf of bread. His simplicity and his humility was known far and wide. No wonder when Bergoglio, the cardinal from Buenos Aires, was elected the Bishop of Rome, he took on the name of Francis of Assisi. And the moment he took on that name, I knew he wanted to walk in the footsteps of this little poor man, following his example of simplicity, poverty, and humility. And Pope Francis is a wonderful example of that simplicity, humility, touching the lives of so many people, just like Francis of Assisi. Today, let us pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, in a very special way. He's doing amazing things, reaching out to so many people in all his simplicity, like Francis of Assisi. And may Saint Francis of Assisi, the patron of our Holy Father, intercede and pray for our Holy Father, that he may touch many more lives. Today is also a very special day, because in Rome, we're going to begin the Synod of Bishops, who will be discussing on family. It begins from the 4th of October and ends on the 25th of October. This is going to be one of the most defining moments for the papacy of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. And I think all of us should show our solidarity with the bishops who will be assembled in Rome. They're going to be more than 279 bishops from about 120 nations, along with 17 families and 17 auditors and other non-voting members who will be present for the Synod. It is a very, very important moment in the history of the Church. They're going to come together to discuss important issues that's affecting families today. They're going to be some factors that will be affecting the Synod. There's going to be lobbying to change certain important decisions of the Church. Let us earnestly pray, dear friends, that the Synod of Bishops may be one in mind and heart, that they may work together to preserve the rich traditions of the Church, that they may bring out decisions through the power of the Holy Spirit that will help build beautiful families, the domestic church, the basic unit of our society and of the Church, so that our families may be healthy families, so that we may have a healthy church and a healthy society.